reading is vicarious experience. These are mostly the miniatures that I wrote stories about when I was a kid. I've reflected on this a lot, and I look back and think of the whole question of memory. I mean, what are we? What shapes us as human beings? I grew up in the projects of Bayonne, New Jersey. We were poor. Other kids would go down the shore for the summer and go to the beach or go to the mountains and with their families. We never went anywhere in the summer. We just stayed in the same old place. But books took me everywhere. I read Lord of the Rings, probably junior high school. You know, it opens like with a dissertation on pipeweed. And then there's the birthday party. And I'm saying, where are the giant snakes? Where are the scantily clad women? There's no sword fights here. What's going on? But then it started picking up steam. Rivendell and the Black Riders. By the time I got to the Mines of Moria, I had decided that this was the greatest book that I'd ever read.
The Lord of the Rings describes the epic struggle of a band of humans and elves, led by a wizard named Gandalf and a hobbit called Frodo, who embark on a journey to save their world from evil. One popular interpretation of Tolkien's novel looks at it as an exploration of the famous phrase, power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely.
It was so totally immersive. Tolkien approached this thing as if he was writing history. He had genealogies that went back not only hundreds, but thousands of years, the rise and fall of kingdoms, entire stories in a footnote. That grounded this in reality so much. Tolkien's greatest invention was the characters who struggle with the temptation of the ring and what to do with it. They're all fighting these battles inside their hearts. That can take place anywhere, in any time, in any space in all of human history. And then Gandalf dies. I can't explain the impact that had on me at 13. You can't kill Gandalf. I mean, Conan didn't die in the Conan books, you know? Tolkien just broke that rule. And I love him forever for it. Because the minute you kill Gandalf, the suspense of everything that follows is 1,000 times greater. Because now anybody could die. And of course, it's had a profound effect on my own willingness to kill characters at the drop of a hat. I'm thrilled that Game of Thrones is on the list. What I wanted to do was take certain of the traditions of fantasy, but meld to it a level of grittiness and realism. Your books, your stories should reflect what you see in the real world around you. Even a fantasy that has dragons should reflect the truth. To be on the same list with Lord of the Rings is very exciting. If you are one of the six people in the world who has not yet read J.R.R. Tolkien's Lord of the Rings, what are you waiting for? Read Lord of the Rings, and if you like it as much as I do, vote for it.